Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you how we can prepare presentation for research paper, which you usually need to present in your lab meetings or lab groups. And this presentation can also be helpful for designing your presentation for research proposal, synopsis, and which is also called as opening report. And it would also will be equally helpful for thesis defense as well. So rather than telling that how to design PowerPoint, I will show you a real-time example so that you can exactly format your presentation according to this. So as here in this slide, you can see on the top, you can see I have written research presentation. So whatever you are going to present, so you can write a small wording, like whether it is research proposal or opening report or thesis defense. So I can minimize it. You can see here I have pasted research presentation. So whatever is your content, so you can paste that address. And here you can see this is our title. So this can be your research paper title or opening report title. And here can be the presenter name. So if you are going to present your thesis or proposal, so of course you are going to mention the name of your supervisor or advisor as well. And it would be nice if you can add your university image, or otherwise keeping it simple would be even more better. And it is also would be okay if you can add any monogram as well. So if you are preparing like interview presentation, so you can also paste monogram of respective universities as well. So we can go back and start with real-time example. So here you can see the first thing which we should mention in our first slide of any presentation, that should be the content. And here should be the division of content. And as we know that the content should be begin with background and introduction. So after background and introduction, we should have material and methods. And the next, we should have objectives and technical routes. So later on, I will tell you where these objectives and technical routes are not needed. And the later part should be the results. And then should be the discussion. And the later on should be summary. And at the last, we can mention acknowledgement and collaboration as well. So now I will tell you there should be how long and there should be how many slides. Like I will say for each slide there should be 1 minute, although there can be exception. Sometime you need to spend more than 1 minute on one slide, and sometime you may be even need to spend only 45 seconds depending upon the content of slide. So but on an average, I would say for 1 minute for one slide. So on an average, for background and introduction, there should be only 3 to 4 slides for research paper. But if you are dealing with thesis, so you can increase the content up to 20 to 30%. So it means then it can be 5 to 6 slides. And then the material and methods, I think so there are only 1 to 2 slides, which can be enough. And the next one is objectives and technical route. There should be only 1 slide for objectives, and there should be only 1 slide for technical route. And make sure these objectives and technical routes slides are only essential when you are preparing the presentation for your thesis or proposal. So there is no need to present objectives and technical route slides when you are presenting anybody else research paper in your lab group. And then of course the important part, which is the results. So that can be up to 7 to 10 slides. So if you are giving thesis defense, so of course 30% would be increased, like this can be 13 to 15 slides. And the last one is discussion. And sometime this section can also be omitted, which is also only 1 to 2 slides. And the next one is the summary, which can be only 1 slide. So let's go into a real-time example, and I will show you how we can prepare background and introduction. So as here you can see in the background and introduction, I did not mention any number. And here you can see I have just used the same format of fonts like here, although I like Arials and Times New Roman. So whatever, it is your choice, but it is important to keep the whole formatting in that same font. So it means if you are using Times New Roman, so keep all the fonts in the Times New Roman. So here you can see I have just pasted a small heading, and then I tried to paste one graphics from this publication. And it is important to note that if you are pasting anything or any figure, it is important to mention its reference, and please do not copy as such figures from Wikipedia, because at university level you need to write the references of your publication in terms of this. And here you can see I have pasted two figures from two different publications, and in this slide you can notice that there are only few words, like here maybe only 10 to 15 words and two graphics. So the best presentation is that presentation which have very less amount of wording and very good quality graphics, because it will appeal the reviewers and your presentation will impress the reviewers. And the next slide, here you can see I have defined that the plant hormone cytokine promotes meristem initiation, and it is also important that you can mention the important slides through these circles. So if you are presenting anything in the form of table and you want to mention something important, so you can add this highlight option, and you can also add transitions. So how to add transitions, let me show you. Like here you want to add, there is this tab, home tab, and you can go to this transition tab and you can add anything. Like if you want to add this circle, so you can simply go to this insert. You can, like if you want to paste oval shape, so you can paste it like this, and you can go to shape fill, you can search, choose no fill. So you can see here, and if we want to add transition, so now we can go to animations and we can simply add fly in transition. But as in this case I have already added, so there is no need. So we can go back, and here you can see, because cytokinin signaling was important from histidine kinase receptor, so these are the important, so the important things you can also mention with these highlighters. So, and how they are responding to the different regulators. And here I have actually tried to told that how two component system, I mean the histidine kinase receptor and the response regulator, how they coordinate and control the cytokinin signaling. So here you can see I have only given 15 to 20 words and try to give my idea. And the next slide, it is always good to connect the previous story with the next question. Here you can see which response regulator received the cytokinin signals from the cytokinin receptor OSHK4. So then here you can see I have switched to next part, that is material and method. And here, although I have tried that how you created your mutant and how the wild type and the microenvironment and the microenvironment conditions, I mean where you planted your all plants and material, or where you took your soil. So it is up to you that how you address this slide. So you can deal it with your own major. And the next slide is important, the result. So here you can see when you are presenting the results, so you can give a major finding in the form of heading. And then here you can see we are pasting the only the one whole main figure. And it is also important to note that there is no need to write any figure number. Like I can take you to this research paper here. You can see this is actually a research paper. And here you can see here is actually figure number one. So some people do what actually do, they will just crop this whole figure, including this figure number one. So there is no need to be so lazy that even you are just not removing the figure number from the original article. So there is no need to mention the figure number in your presentation. So then you can move to next results, and here you can see this is actually again one heading, and this heading actually is telling the all the results in the form of different figures. So you can go one by one and try to explain how the stories go begins, and you can keep on telling the story, and you can keep on explaining the different results only in the form of these figures. So if you are afraid that you will forget anything, or if you want to add something abbreviation which you are afraid that while presenting you will forget, so you can add those things because in these notes, because these notes will be only visible to your presentation, and all the audience cannot see these notes. So if you want to add something for your own, so you can add here. So we can go ahead and try to present our all results in the form of these figures, and you can also add few more wording, like up to one line or two line, it's okay if you want to add. And similarly, you can also present your results in the form of figures or tables, and make sure that you are copying high quality figures from original their website. You can go to that online HTML version of that research article, and you can download high quality figure and paste it here. And here is next again 7 to 10 slides for results, and then we can move to the last part, that is a proposed model for the role of PAL. So because I will not go into the detail of this thing, what how it works, but my actual purpose was to tell you that how actually a good presentation look like. A good presentation, you can see, has beautiful graphics and has same formatting for all the text, and at the last you can go to the summary, and here you can see the summary is only like 4 to 5 lines. There is no need to like give a cumbersome text here, so you can keep it simple, because simple would be beautiful. And at the last you can also add your acknowledgements and collaborations. You can write your collaborators, you can paste anything from a good picture from your lab, and you can mention few collaborations if you have. And the last important thing, which is it would be polite to ask question if needed. So this was the general flow of any presentation, whether it is for research paper or research proposal, synopsis, opening report, or thesis defense. So hopefully this would be helpful in your future presentation. If you have still any question, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.